Good morning. Good morning, Grand Rising, everyone. This is your man, Troy, RCG Consulting, LLC. With today's word is restore, restoration. I heard a podcast today from one of the organizations that I sit on the board for, Friends of Zane Adams, FASA, and its amazing leader, executive director, Ms. Paulette Smith. And it was just another phenomenal broadcast that everybody should listen to these podcasts, but especially the women, especially the Black and Brown, Latino, Latina women, right? But all women should listen to the FASA podcast. And it reminded me of just if people could do things differently when it comes to women going through the maternal wellness and the maternal health concerns. And oftentimes, too many times, it leads to maternal suicide. And restore just came into my mind and my spirit because I've spoken about the restoration process. If we could go back to a time, you know, on a computer, you have a backup and restore option. So if something goes wrong, you could just pick a date and time that you want to restore your computer back to. And I talk about this with the human touch. If you could take your life back to another date and time, what would that date be? And what would you do when you arrived back at that time? What would you do differently? So to restore something in your life, for me, it would be going back and spending a few more minutes with my late mother just to, again, edify her and let her know that she did everything that a mother could possibly do to instill value into a son. That's what I would do. But there's many instances in my life where I would love to restore and go back, and I would do things a little differently. But I want to speak to the women that are possibly going through something now, during or after your pregnancy, that there are resources out there for you that you can turn to. One of the topics or the conversation pieces in the recent podcast was a woman who has three children, just had given birth, and, you know, she was overwhelmed because she really didn't have a support system, and she went in the bathroom and was crying. And luckily, this woman did reach out to a bunch of her friends on FaceTime, and the advice they gave her, according to the professional on this podcast, and I immediately knew that this advice was wrong. They told her to suck it up and to take a shower and just cry it out in the shower. That she didn't want her husband to see her in this weakened state and to just be the diva that she has always been. Such wrong advice. But I know that better now as sitting on the board for this incredible organization, FASA, right? I wouldn't have known that, but I might have said the same thing if I didn't understand. But, and this is, I'm a man, right? Knowing this. So I'm really speaking to the women out there because other women, your friends, your sisters are going to turn to you. And oftentimes those signals are overlooked. And then we're left asking ourselves, why did this happen? But it's too late because the woman has taken her life and she's left a child behind in many instances. So as a man, I want to just, you know, just talk to everybody because this This should not happen. We should understand and embrace the signals and know the advice to give to that woman that, again, has reached out. She's reached out. And when they reach out, we have to know what to do and what to say. So I just want to, again, have everybody out there, especially our women, restore yourself, restore your thoughts, take it back to a different time and a different place, but understand what is out there as far as resources that you can help other women out there and talk about these things, and let's just uplift, you know, the community, the world of women, because you truly are God's gift to us all, right? You are the nurturers of us all. There is not one person out there that can say that they were not birthed from a woman. So you are everything to us. And my mom was everything to me, my best friend, everything. I could tell my mother anything. And trust me, I'll talk about this on another occasion. I told her things and she just sometimes, boy, you ain't got to tell me that. But she was my best friend, right? And that's the type of relationship we had. And she was my biggest supporter and did so much for me as a single mom that, again, I just can't thank her enough for what she's done in my life. But you women are so important to me. I respect you. I'm dedicated to uplifting you. I don't have to know you. Many women have just thanked me in my videos and just sent me comments. And I do this because I truly do love you. I truly do care for you. And I want you to be the best that you could be in whatever you're trying to do in your life. So if I can help you in any way, I'm going to do that. Again, I sit on four different boards and three of them are directly supporting women. And the other one is indirectly supporting women because it's for everybody in communities across the world. So I just want you to know, restore. Think about going back to a place that you could do something differently. Renew your thoughts, yourself, right? And reset your life. Put it in motion and refresh yourself every chance you get, whether it's a nice bubble bath with the candles, a little glass of wine, going to the gym, going for a walk, just getting out and enjoying nature and breathing fresh air, sunlight, whatever that may be for you, that's going to put you in that refreshed frame of mind. Make sure you are doing that. And again, you're not alone. For the pregnant women out there getting ready to birth their children, and we are there for you because you're going to be overwhelmed. Your hormones are going to be just going crazy. That's normal. That's normal. So don't think that you're alone. Don't cry it out. Go to FOZA, right? www.fozainc.org. They have something called FOZA Finders that you could put in your zip code wherever you are, and they're going to give you a whole slew of resources in your specific area. So thank you so much for listening to me. And I will just close out as I always do. Don't nobody love you more than Troy, but God. Have an amazing day. Make it special on purpose. And let's just continue to uplift one another. Take care. God bless.